Tonight, Edo State government flags off free bus service to cushion effects of subsidy removal in the state. Esam of Benin wraps up 89th birthday celebration. Plus, Nigeria's foremost chartered accountant, Akintola Williams, takes a bow at 104 years. A very good evening to you and welcome to NTA Benin News at 7. I am Udwakobong Achibong. Edo State Governor Godwin Obaseki has flagged off free bus service for passengers in all Edo City transport routes to alleviate the adverse effect of fuel subsidy removal on the residents in the state. Goodluck Inani, who captured the takeoff of the exercise in Benin City, now reports.
The free transportation service put in place by the Edo State government is to cushion the effects of the removal of subsidy by the federal government. This, according to the state government, will last up to November 11th.
Citizens of Edo State will in the next 2 months enjoy the free bus service, just as the Commissioner for Communication and Orientation, Chris Nahihari, flags off the exercise on behalf of the state governor, Godwin Obaseki.
The state government takes the welfare of Edo people very seriously, and this is just one of the many ways.
A visit to the ECTS bus at King's Square and at Ramat Park revealed a hive of activity. Some of the commuters, who before now spend over 50% of their income on transportation, lauded the initiative.
Everybody like it. People, they pray for the governor since.
They heard it that it's going to be free transport, but we never expected that it's going to exceed within Benin.
We are looking forward to more of this kind.
I've never seen free bus once. I'm very excited.
I was surprised when they said free bus.
While the free fare intercity service conveys commuters from 8 a.m. daily, ECTS terminals on Forestry Road and Ramat Park will commence operation to Uzeba and Utuo in Owa at 2 p.m. as well as from ECTS Ramat Park to Auchi, Igara, Ososo, Ibilo, Ubiaja, Uromi, Ewato, Ewoimad, Abudu, with departure time at 8 a.m. The gesture will last for 2 months and may probably be extended. In Benin, Goodluck Inani, NTA News.
And turning to judicial matters, the Edo State National Assembly Election Petition Tribunal sitting in Benin has delivered judgment in favor of Akpatterson Peter of APC in the petition filed by a mobile Marvelous Godwin of Labour Party. Rosemary Omani reports that in the petition, Omabayo Marvelous Godwin and the Labour Party are contesting the declaration of Akpatterson Peter as winner of the Akokwedo Federal Constituency election. The candidate and his party alleged that the outcome of the said election was inconclusive as the conduct was characterized by some irregularities. In its judgment, the tribunal dismissed the petition for want of evidence and subsequently affirmed the election of the APC candidate Akpatterson Peter. In the same vein, the tribunal also dismissed the petition of Obaze Osaro of APC challenging the election of Yawe Esosa of Labour Party for a Uedo federal constituency for want of evidence. The tribunal is expected to deliver more judgments on Tuesday. And to other matters now, Nigerians are recommending a new model of governance that places emphasis on knowledge and competence of political leaders, as well as constant education of voters on the importance of their roles in the electoral process. This, they say, will enrich the nation's democratic system and translate to good governance, the hallmark of democracy. Agata Iguare Oju reports.
Since the return of democracy in 1999, effective governance at all levels, many Nigerians believe, is a major challenge the nation is grappling with. Though elections are essential for decision-making in a democracy and builds the foundation for good governance, a credible, transparent and acceptable process driven by enlightened voters on the competence of political leaders will raise the bar in governance.
Many times, many people aspire to become come to any political office they want to aspire to get to. At the end of the day, they think about themselves first.
We have so many people who are not ready for election, were not ready for election, but they were called upon to force them there. And you don't expect anybody that you force in anything be able to get results from that person.
Homogos Elephanta are the resources that we have. You find that the vast majority of the people are still scraping a miserable existence. And that's because these resources are not evenly distributed. Again, you need to emasculate the space for critical thinking. That, of course, again, is missing. When people do not deepen their understanding of a process, they are...
Especially among youths who are demanding good governance, stakeholders say it is urgent to get the system working.
People want so much by way of personal gratification from their elected officials, instead of seeking for the overall good, we must look for people that we can hold accountable. If you didn't buy my vote, I willingly gave it to you, and you are not doing well, I can call you to order.
That was a year Oba Market got born. When he got born, many people were going around stealing from there. They brought pastor, they brought imam. They need authority. But the time they brought their own traditional way, you see that night, people returned everything they took from that market, both money and all. I think Nigeria can also see replicate that thing in terms of governance. Even you as a traditional ruler, if you take that oath, you will not be able to let anything miss from your community.
We need to deal and appreciate the cancer of religion and ethnicity, particularly when they are deployed as an opportunistic tool.
With the Tinubu's administration of Renewed Hope, stakeholders expressed the conviction that the roadblocks to a strong democracy that guarantees effective governance through the electoral process will be surmounted. In Benin, Agatha Egwari Uju, NTN News.
A quick reminder that you can catch the news live on our YouTube channel, NTN Benin. Reach out to us in the newsroom on any breaking news and happenings in Edo State via the number 091-535-59648. You can also send WhatsApp messages to the same number. We now take a break. We'll be back shortly. Please stay tuned.
The Oracle of Okada is 89. I, Honorable Collins Osamedi Ogbewe, Chairman of Obia Northeast Local Government Area, on behalf of myself, family members, and the people of Obia Northeast, your primary constituency, I congratulate our Red Gem for this milestone. The uncommon gift to humanity and remain a living legend celebrated at home and abroad for your thawing accomplishment. You put Okada Hitithrow, a small and sleeping town, on a national and global sphere, and we are proud of the prominent role you continue to play as an editor. Statesman contributing to nation building. It is impossible to document individual contributions to the development of Edo State without acknowledging your frontline role in many aspects: economy, politics, sport, entertainment, aviation, manufacturing, broadcasting, education. The list goes on and on. As we join you to celebrate, we pray that God will continue to honor you, grant you the good health, and give you long life. Signed, Honorable Collins Osamede Ogbewe, Chairman of your Northeast Local Government Area. Senator Barrister Neda Imaswen felicitate with Esama at 89. I, Senator Barrister Neda Imaswen, on behalf of my family and the good people of Edo South Senatorial District of Edo State, felicitate with our own esteemed father, Sir Chief Dr. Gabriel Sawau Ibinidion, CFRO, the Esama of Benin Kingdom, on the occasion of the celebration of his 89th birthday anniversary. Sir, I salute your dexterity and courage in navigating life for these 89 years, touching so many lives. You have been a blessing passing to your generation and generations yet unborn. Your political and economic contributions to our state and national development remain a marvel to us all. I pray to God Almighty to grant you many more years in good health. Signed, Senator Barrister Neda Imasuen, Chairman, Senator Committee on Ethics, Privileges and Public Petition. Congratulations to the Esama of Benin Kingdom on the occasion of his 89th birthday celebration. I, Honorable Modi Usaigbovu, the Honorable Commissioner for Local Government, Community and Chieftaincy Affairs, felicitate with the Esama of Benin Kingdom on the occasion of his 89th birthday anniversary. I rejoice with the Esama and his entire household as they celebrate and pray God to grant him many more years of celebrations. Esama, you've been a blessing to mankind and I've written your name in the sand of time. You've been a blessing to many households as you have been a source of livelihood to many families in Edo State in particular and the nation in general. Once again, I wish you happy birthday and many happy returns. Congratulations. Signed, Honorable Mondi Osaigbovu, Commissioner for Local Government, Community and Chieftaincy Affairs, Edo State.
On behalf of the Siwon Bell Catholic Women Organization of Nigeria, Benin Ecclesiastical Province, we thank God for your life as you celebrate your 88th birthday. May God bless you abundantly. Your life of humility, kindness, and devotion to your family, friends, and the church has been a source of joy and strength for all. On this joyous occasion, may you soar higher, His Excellency Sir Chief Dr. Gabriel Sawaru Ibinyeta. My life.
Honorable Eitan Osazeme Uzame, Commissioner for Road and Bridges, celebrate Esama of Benin at 89. I, Honorable Eitan Osazeme Uzame, which is to felicitate and celebrate an icon, the Lion of Okada, and Honorary Ambassador to Romanian Vuedo and Delta State, His Excellency Sir Chief Dr. Gabriel Sawaru Ibinyeta CFIR, on the auspicious occasion of his 89th birthday anniversary. Your Excellency, sir, I'm proud to be associated with you on this occasion. I pray God to grant you good health and sound mind to continue to excel in all your endeavors. I also, on behalf of my family, wish you happy birthday and many happy returns. As you celebrate this year, may God continue to grant you many more years and grace to continue to celebrate. God bless Esama. God bless the Lion. Long may you reign. Signed, Honorable Eitan Osazeme Uzame, Commissioner, Road and Bridges, Edo State.
Next time you visit the ancient city of Benin, two things will excite you. The warmth and welcome of its people, and of course, the class and style of its hospitality business. Rendeki Gold, home of hospitality like no other, located in one of the most serene environments in the ancient city, truly classy and exquisite with world-class facilities. Fully equipped digital multi-purpose hall with life-size ultra-high definition LED screen, 180 square meters king-size swimming pool with bubble bath, enough to leave you breathless. The exotic Ariel's Bistro and Grill restaurant with variety of continental dishes, especially some of the rarest delicacies you can find in town. Fact is, a visit will truly convince you that we are gold. Rendeki Gold is the gold wing of the prestigious Rendeki Royal Hotel at 6 Uhenuyi Street off Ihama and Boundary Roads, GRA Benin City, www.rendekihotels.com. Rendeki Gold, our hospitality is gold.
Yeah.
Right Honorable Murphy Osaro Omowi, celebrate with Esama at 89. On behalf of myself and family and the entire citizens of Ego Ikpobaoka Federal Constituency in Edo State, I celebrate the great Esama of Benin Kingdom on the occasion of his celebration of his 89th birthday anniversary. I thank God for longevity of life for our father, Sir Chief Dr. Gabriel Sawari Benedion CFR, as he continues to work stronger in the glory of our Lord. I pray that as he celebrates, God will grant him his heart's desires and give him good health and sound mind to continue to be a blessing to mankind. You have indeed written your name in the sands of time. As generation yet unborn, we continue to celebrate your lifetime achievement to the delight of every one of us. Once again, I say happy birthday and congratulations. Signed, Right Honorable Murphy Osaro Omowi, member representing Ego and Ikpobaoka Federal Constituency in Edo State.
Many thanks for staying tuned. His grace is sufficient is the theme of the 89th birthday celebration of the Sam of Benin, Chief Gabriel Osawari Igbinedion. Ogochukwu Kaonna was in the early morning interdenominational service at his residence to mark his day.
Ushering family and guests from all corners and continents of the world into the Garden of Eden venue for the service was praise to God for his faithfulness over the years. The guest preacher and president, General Superintendent, Gospel Light International Ministries, Reverend Felix Omobude, took his message from Psalm 71, and part of it says, "Without God, humans are nothing, and with Him, they are everything." He described the celebrant as a man amongst men in his true meaning, a pathfinder, a trailblazer, and one of great courage and compassion.
Who is this man? Very thoughtful person, from a very humble beginning, he's become a household name, he's dined with kings and rulers, with nobles. He's been there to the top, yet he has respect even for the lowly. That is Igbinedion.
This was followed by prayers for the Esama by the clergy present.
I pray specifically for the health of your son. I speak into every tissue, every vein, every blood vessel, every cell, every nerve, every organ, every bone and marrow, every joint. You are whole. You are well. Amen. You will continue to be well. Amen.
The joy of the immediate family is here expressed in words.
I want to thank God for seeing today and him being healthy and happy, surrounded by those that loves him and that he loves. There's no greater joy than to be surrounded by the people that you feel comfortable with. You know, so it's a truly remarkable day. And cause for joy and celebration.
The celebrant, an entrepreneur and philanthropist of great repute, owes his success story to God, hence the caption, "His grace is sufficient."
I'm grateful for the occasion. You can see for yourself. You made the judgment. God bless you.
Adina, to wrap up the 11 days birthday activities, is holding right about now at his number 1 to 13 Okada Avenue residence, GRA Benin City. In Benin, Ogochukwu Kaona, NTA News.
Nice one there. We here, we wish Esam of Benin a happy birthday. And moving on, it was a moment of joy for the parents and loved ones of little Master Shine Amadi as he celebrated 1 year birthday. Ifomo Kafo brings us a sight and sound from the event.
The celebrant, little Master Shine Amadi, thrilled the guests by his magnificent entrance to the arena, as that set the tone for the event. Children as fun seekers in their usual ways took the center stage in celebrating Shine. For the parents of the celebrant, Mr. and Mrs. Amadi Arawa, the birth of Shine is a blessing to them. Others prayed for him.
He's going to grow in good health, wisdom, prosperity, understanding. By the grace of God, I am his father. I did this for him. He's going to do more than this for all his children.
Being the mother of the celebrant, I feel very blessed. I feel honored. By the grace of Almighty God, we celebrated this birthday in good health, in peace.
Seeing them doing all this kind of celebration, it's a great happiness to me. See my brother, son celebrating a big celebration like this. I'm very, very happy. I feel on top of the world.
The purpose of celebrating this birthday, it shall never be in vain in the name of Jesus. It will live to testify the goodness of God, and it will grow old and it will celebrate the father and the mother that did it for him.
They prayed God to continue to keep Shine in good health. In Benin, Ifeoma Okafo, NTA News.
It was tribute galore for the immediate past Minister of State for Budget and National Planning, Prince Clem Agba, as guests lauded him for what they described as his exemplary performance as a member of cabinet in the immediate past administration of Muhammadu Buhari. This was at the award event held recently in Benin in his honor at the instance of the Nigerian Union of Journalists Edo State Council. The report.
A gathering of dignitaries who converged on the press center of the Edo State Council of the Nigerian Union of Journalists, NUJ, to honor Clem Agba, they believe had through his remarkable supervisory role at the Budget and National Planning Ministry set a standard for successive ministers to keep up with. The chairman of NUJ in the state, Festus Alenga, said journalists in Edo State had investigated and considered Clem Agba for the honor.
It meant a result that somebody who has always supported us all along, this kind of person needs to be given this kind of recognition. I want to say heartily that you merit this recognition.
Dr. Seminge Egbon, who is also a veteran journalist, noted that as a long-standing patron of NUJ in the state, he is abreast of the achievement and support of Prince Agba to the union, which will open doors for him.
In every century, God gives a child to a people that will uplift them, and that is Clement Agba.
Chairman on the occasion, High Chief Shehu Musa Isiwele, described the former minister as a great leader and performer who is widely respected for his immense contributions to Edo State and Nigerian society.
I never know minister works. I was thinking they just had Abuja over the weekend, but it claimed surprise us. I went to his place, Zanu. I know what he did in Edo North. I know what he did in Edo.
Others who spoke at the event were Mr. Sunday Dare, immediate past Minister of Youth and Sports Development, and Prince Godik Jedi, also an immediate past Minister of State for Power. Prince Lem Agba, a royalty and son to the departed Eliola, king of Uneme Uzanu Kingdom of Etsako East Local Government Area of the state, used the opportunity to speak on some of the highlights of his stewardship as a minister of state in Benin.
Time for another break. We'll be back shortly. Please stay tuned.
2 years in mind, gone but not forgotten. We, the family of late Elder Stephen Agbonogbearuoyi Irurere, JP, remember today our dearly beloved husband, father, and grandfather, Daddy. Today makes it 2 years since you left us on this earth. We honor and cherish your memory and legacy that you left behind. We miss your voice, presence, and heartfelt messages. We give glory to God for being our solace and source of strength since you have been gone. Your memory lives on in every corner of our lives. We miss your healthy laughter and the warmth of your embrace. You are not just a father and grandfather, you are a guiding light, a source of unwavering love and support. Though you are no longer with us in the physical sense, your hard work continues to inspire us. You taught us the importance of family, the value of kindness, and the beauty of a life well lived. Fondly remembered and deeply missed by your devoted wife, loving children, and adoring grandchildren. Signed, Engineer Osayine C. Wallace Irureri, MNSE, for the family. Dr. Mrs. Joanne Osa Oviawe, felicitate with Esama of Benin at 89. I, Dr. Mrs. Joanne Osa Oviawe, rejoices with the Esama of Benin Kingdom, the Lion of Okada, Sir Chief Dr. Gabriel Osawawi Benedion, CFRO, the Esama of Benin Kingdom, as he celebrates his 89th birthday anniversary. As you celebrate, I pray God to bless you and grant you the grace to continue to celebrate. You are a beacon of hope to many of us, as you have always been engaged in providing for the poor and the less privileged in the society. I wish you many years of celebrations with good health and sound mind, and your remaining years of blissful existence on earth. Once again, happy birthday, my father, and many happy returns. Signed, Dr. Mrs. Joanne Osa Oviawe, Honorable Commissioner, Ministry of Education, Edo State.
Right Honorable Mofio Saro Omoyi, celebrate with Esama at 89. On behalf of myself and family and the entire citizens of Ego Ikpoba Oka Federal Constituency in Edo State, I celebrate the great Esama of Benin Kingdom on the occasion of his celebration of his 89th birthday anniversary. I thank God for longevity of life for our father, Sir Chief Dr. Gabriel Sawari Benedion CFR, as he continues to work stronger in the glory of our Lord. I pray that as he celebrates, God will grant him his heart's desires and give him good health and sound mind to continue to be a blessing to mankind. You have indeed written your name in the sands of time. As generation yet unborn, we continue to celebrate your lifetime achievement to the delight of every one of us. Once again, I say happy birthday and congratulations. Signed, Right Honorable Mofio Saro Omoyi, Member representing Ego and Igbobaka Federal Constituency in Edo State.
Miracle of the Black Race is 89, a record breaker and history maker, pillar of support to many, great employer of labor, philanthropist. It is the time of the year again we gather to celebrate your birth anniversary, a birth that has added immense value to the human race and the Edo Nation. You love and flaunt with pride. You have contributed immensely to the human capital, socio-economic and political development of Edo State and nation. What area will you mention and you don't see the mark of Esama? I'm proud to be associated with a dogged man who never gives up in the face of challenges, an industrialist, an investor who has and is raising people and homes through acts of generosity, Domo Baba, Lion of Okada, Iroko of Ovia, the Oracle. May you live long in good health while the children you have groomed and touched in one way or the other continue to celebrate you. Signed, Honorable Matthew Egbunweze Idoyikime.
Capri Sun Funland. Can't wait. Hey!
Entry denied.
No artificial colors. No artificial sweeteners. No preservatives.
Access granted.
Next up, the water slide.
Quick fun and great taste. Capri Sun. The taste of fun. Capri Sun.
a product of Chi Limited.
Many thanks for staying tuned. Edo State Governor Godwin Obaseki has mourned the passage of elder statesman and doyen of accounting in Nigeria, Chief Akintola Williams, who died aged 104 years. Statement by the governor says Chief Akintola Williams lived a fulfilled life, having made his mark as the first Nigerian to qualify as a chartered accountant that led most accomplished professionals in the corporate world. He says Chief Akintola Williams will be remembered for his knack for excellence, quest for truth and justice. The governor commiserates with the Williams family, friends and associates, and prays for God to grant them the fortitude to bear their irreparable loss. And on that note, we'll wrap up our bulletin for tonight. Many thanks for watching. Good evening.